In this tutorial, I'm going to show you 7 of my favorite super quick and useful text animations. These can be used in any number of projects, and they can all be saved as animation presets. If you're not sure how to do that, check out the link in the description below. We'll be using text animators for this tutorial, which can be a little intimidating, but don't worry. I'll show you exactly what you need to know to create these super cool text animations. There's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so for this first text animation, we're going to reveal this one word at a time. You may have used a preset in After Effects called Typewriter. If you just type that into your effects and presets, you'll see it right here under Text Animate In. Put your plate at the beginning of your animation and double click Typewriter. Select the layer and press U, and you'll see you have your keyframes here. Without doing anything, it just reveals your text like that. And that may be something that you're interested in using, but you can also reveal this one word at a time. So let's go back to the beginning of our animation, close, and then open back up your range selector. Open up Advanced, and let's change this from characters to words. Now, if you just click the stopwatch for start, it will get rid of your keyframes. Click it again to create a keyframe at 0% and just scrub forward till you see your first word. Right click, go to toggle hold keyframe. I'm just going to shift page down one time to go for 10 frames, but you can actually line this up to audio and just move forward in time and just increase this start percentage until each word animates on like that. Watch it play back, and now you have one word coming on at a time. And the cool thing about all these animations is that they can be saved as animation presets. I do have a tutorial that goes over that in depth, but just real quick, what you need to do is make sure that you select your animator and the transform properties, and then go to animation, save animation preset. You do not want to select your text or the source text right here, because that will save the actual text that you're using, and chances are you'll be changing your text every time. So I recommend just select animator and your transform properties. Okay, so for this next effect right here, let's go ahead and open up our text layer and go to the Animate button, and let's add in a position text animator. And now Shift-Command-N to create a new mask that goes around your text. Now we can just move our position down like that, so that way it's not revealed within this area right here. Open up our range selector, advanced, and I'm going to make a few changes here. I have a ton of tutorials on text animators. If you use these settings, it will get you through most of the animations that you need. Let's change our shape from square to ramp up. I'm going to base this on words instead of characters. I'm going to increase my ease low, which is ease in, to 100%. And by changing this to ramp up, this changes our offset properties. If you're at square, your offset properties start at 0% and go up to 100% for the entire animation. So if you go below 0%, you get some kind of weird effects. Once you change it to ramp up, your range is now negative 100%. That's your starting place. Shift page down twice to go for 20 frames and increase this to 100%. Make sure this first keyframe is actually negative 100. So if we watch that play back, it'll come up like that, just one word at a time. And it's revealed within that mask. So now I want this to animate in and then also animate up. So in order to animate this up, take this animator 1, control D to duplicate that. As you can see, this is our animator 2 now, and here's our animator 1. This is the first animator we created. Here's the second one. So let's open up that other animator and move these keyframes down. We just need to make a few changes. Okay, so we're going to go to our position. We had it set to 108. Make that a negative. Whatever value you have, just make that a negative. Change ramp up to ramp down. So now this is the effect we get. Okay, and so now I want to replace this text. So let's go to this last keyframe here and Alt Option Right Bracket to trim that. And now we can duplicate this layer. So Control D, go to this keyframe right here and Shift Page Down one time. So that way we're right in the middle of these two keyframes. Left bracket to move that text over. Now I'm just going to change my text. V to grab your selector tool, then right click on this mask, go to Mask, Reset Mask. This text comes in like that and it animates up and is followed by our next text layer. U to bring up our keyframe. I'm going to do this one more time. Control D to duplicate, left bracket to move it over, shift page down one time, left bracket to move it over one more time. Change your text. It's super easy. V to grab your selector tool, right click, mask, reset mask. So this is the full animation that we have now. Okay, so for this next effect, we're going to do a 3D blur multi-line animation. So let's open up our text layer, enable per character 3D. Then we want to add in a position text animator. Then within that animator, we want to add in a few more things. We want to add in an opacity and also add in a blur. So let's move our position back. I'll say negative 1500 pixels on the Z axis. Open up our range selector. Open up advanced. And again, we're going to go ramp up. Ease low is going to be 100%. This is going to make our offset negative 100%, shift page down twice, put a keyframe for 100%. So we have something that looks kind of like that, but we're going to make it look a lot more interesting. So let's go down to our opacity set our opacity to 0%, set our blur to 100, and then turn the randomize order on. And this is the kind of animation that you get. Now, if you want this to animate right back out, all you have to do is grab these keyframes, copy, go down a little bit, paste. With both keyframes selected, right-click Keyframe Assistant, Time Reverse Keyframes. So now it will animate in and then also animate out with all the characters coming in and out randomly. Okay, so now let's scale this text layer up per character. So let's add in a text animator. We're going to add in a scale. And let's just unconstrain our scale, set the Y scale value to 0. Open up our range selector, advanced, and again, we're going to go ramp up, ease low 100%. We're going to leave it at per characters, keyframe on offset, make that negative 100%, shift page down twice, make that 100%. So now let's take that animator, control D to duplicate that, open up this second text animator, grab these keyframes, and go to the 10th frame and move those keyframes down. Now all we have to do is change our scale from 100, 0 to 100, 125. And also we're going to change our ease low to 0 and our ease high to 100%. Watch that playback. And this is the kind of animation that you get. So if you want this scale to go up higher, just change this maybe to like 150. Get something a little bit more exaggerated. If you want it more subdued, make it a little bit smaller. So we'll say 115. Okay, so let's do something really cool with this next text animation. Go to Animate, and we're going to add in a tracking text animator. Pull this in so it's like that. And then within that animator, we want to add in a position. Let's move this down. We also want to add in an opacity. We're going to set this opacity to 0%. So now if we open up a range selector, instead of using offset and making these changes under the Advanced tab, I'm going to leave everything exactly the way it is. We're going to animate using the start percentage. So put a keyframe for start at 0%. Shift page down twice to go 20 frames, increase that to 100%. Okay, and then we're gonna add in one more text animator here. So let's close that up. Make sure you do not have text animator one selected. Instead, select text, go to animate, and add in another tracking. We're gonna put a keyframe for tracking amount and make sure it lines up with this other keyframe. Shift page down twice, and then let's just increase this so it kind of pops out a little bit. Since we're using our start percentage instead of ease low and using ramp up, we can actually use our graph editor. So select these last three keyframes, F9 to make those easy ease. Now select this keyframe right here, go to your graph editor, and we're going to pull the handle over like that. We're going to pull this handle all the way right and this one all the way left. Now if you watch that playback, we get something like that. And the cool thing about this is you can actually make some changes if you want this to come in from the top. This layer selected, type in POS for position, and here's your animator position. Just make this a negative value. So we'll say negative 175. Watch that playback. And now it comes in from the top. Okay, so this next animation here is something really simple, but it can be very, very cool. Let's open up this text layer, and we're going to go to Animate and Enable Per Character 3D, then also Animate, and we're going to add in a Rotation Text Animator. Let's take our Y rotation, set that to negative 90 degrees, and then we also want to add in an Opacity Text Animator. Before I adjust our opacity, let's open up our range selector. And again, we'll be using the start percentage for this. So we're going to leave this at 0%, shift page down 3 times, go forward 1 second, increase that to 100%. Now let's change our value of our opacity down to 0%. Select both of those, F9 to make those easy ease. I'm going to open this up and I'm just going to do something kind of like a bell shape like this. You can kind of tweak with these settings to get the exact look that you want. And that's our animation right there. Okay, and then for this last text animation, we're going to incorporate color into this animation. So let's open up our text layer, go to Animate, add in a Position Text Animator. We also want to add in an Opacity. We want to add in a Blur, and we want to add in a Fill Color RGB. So I'm going to move my position over. We're going to open up our Range Selector, Advanced, and we're going to change our shape from square to ramp up, ease low to 100%. And that makes our offset range go from negative 100%. Shift page down twice to go forward 20 frames to 100%. So we have something that looks kind of like that. But we're not done just yet. So let's close some of this up. We're going to change our opacity down to 0%. If you unconstrain this, you can now adjust your blur horizontally or vertically. The X value is going to be horizontal, Y is vertical. So I'm going to change my horizontal blur so we have something that looks like that. And as you can see, we can't really see the color animating in on this very well. So let's close up that text animator. We're going to duplicate this. Let's name this first one POS for position, second one color. Okay, so let's open up our position text animator, and now we can just get rid of this fill color right here. If we open up our color, get rid of everything except the color. So the reason why I did it like this is because I wanted the same exact settings on both of these properties. U to bring up our keyframes, and let's just offset our color so it comes in slightly after. We have something like that. And there you have it, 7 super quick and useful text animations in After Effects using text animators. I hope this tutorial helped you out, and I will see you all next time. I want to thank Envato Elements for sponsoring this episode, and also thank my viewers for making this sponsorship possible. For designers, editors, and animators, Envato Elements is an amazing resource. With your membership, you can download unlimited assets for anything you could possibly want or need for your projects. Get access to high-res stock videos and photos, as well as motion graphic templates for titles, video displays, logo animations, lower thirds, infographics, promos, openers, and so much more. You also get access to backgrounds, textures, patterns, and icons, which we all know are vital resources. You get access to music for your sound beds in virtually any style or genre you can possibly imagine for designing the perfect sound for your projects. Speaking of sound design, you have access to Envato Elements' entire sound effects database, which includes any sound you could possibly need or want for anything from short film production to commercials to logo stingers. Every asset comes with commercial and non-commercial licensing at no extra cost, so both you and your clients can produce amazing projects with peace of mind. And again, with your membership, you get unlimited downloads of all of these assets from Envato Elements. Download as much as you want, as often as you want, without ever having to pay for individual projects or files. Check out Envato Elements from the link in the description below and get 70% off the first month. That means you have access to everything from Envato Elements for less than $10. It's an unbelievable deal, and I highly recommend you check it out. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-Minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-Minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.